Today, I'm going to show you how you can start to hit your driver longer and straighter. No gimmicks in this. This works. I've done it with my clients. And the swing model we are using is none other than Bryson DeChambeau. In my opinion, one of the golfing geniuses right now in the game, but also one of the hands down best drivers of the golf ball in the modern game. You do not want to miss this video. So what are some lessons that we can learn from him? Well, we're going to do two things today. And the first thing we're going to do is just freeze Bryson here at address. Now, what I want you to do is just look at his alignments, and more specifically, the first crucial concept, which is straight lines breed accuracy. What do I mean by that? Look at Bryson's lead forearm and the club at address. Now, you will see that he's able to get that lead forearm and the club in one straight line at address. Now, yes, granted, Bryson does have a weak grip, but I can bring up another example of, say, Tommy Fleetwood, and we see exactly the same model. And this is a very, very common model we see out on tour. Now, if I take that same image of Bryson at address, and I now flick it to the image of him at impact, what do you notice about that lead forearm and the driver shaft? It comes back basically to one straight line. And this is where I see so many amateurs go wrong. They don't have these straight lines. And like I said, straight lines are a recipe for accuracy. So what do I mean by this? Well, if you are in a straight line position with the forearm and the shaft at address with your driver, and now you come back to impact, watch this. Here's my setup position. Here's my impact position. You see how there's not much change in terms of the lead forearm and the shaft. There might be a little bit extra shaft lean, but nothing too crazy. Now, if you're a golfer who sets up, and I see this every single day on the lesson tee, with the driver shaft pointing back more so towards the belt buckle, you can now see this lead arm and the shaft are not in one straight line. So now if you want to get back to a functional, good impact position, what have you got to do? You've got to be able to push your hands forwards in the downswing. Now, when you're doing this, you're changing two main things. Number one, you're changing the loft. So it's going to be very hard to get good trajectory, good consistency. But most importantly, you are now changing the club face. As you move the shaft more forwards, the face is going to open up. Hence why you see so many golfers then want to swing over the top, slice it, do all of these horrible things, and they suck off the tee. So if we're going to take a lesson from Bryson, the very first lesson is straight lines breed consistency. And in this situation, we are talking about the shaft and the lead forearm being in one straight line at address. Now, if you just grab the club of your left hand and you just relax it down, you can see this actually naturally wants to fall into this position. And again, you don't have to have the weak grip like Bryson. I'd advocate for more of a stronger grip for a lot of golfers just because it helps square that club face up so much easier. But you can see here, if I just relax that arm, it naturally wants to fall into this position. So once you've done that a couple times, then bring your right hand on without compromising that grip and that left arm being in a nice straight line with the shaft, swing to the top and get used to coming back to this straight line position. I want you to grab some sort of extendable pole, or maybe like a broomstick or a PVC pipe, something that is far longer than a driver. So I'm going to extend this out right here, and you can see if I do this now and I grip this sort of the same length that my driver would be, how I have all of this extending up from the left side of my body. So here's how I want you to train this. I want you to set up to the golf ball as if you're about to hit it. Now you can see this might exaggerate it a little bit, but because this is extending up the left side of my body right here, I can't have my hands too far back at address. So what this does is it's going to make it so much easier for you to learn what it feels like to get the lead forearm and the club in one straight line at address. Now, once you've done this, then what I want you to do is make a backswing and come down super slow and try and get everything to line back up in one straight line to impact. And I just want you to do that just a couple of times. Go back nice and slow, come back down to impact, and allow this to hit just the left side of your body right as you get to impact right there. Now, if I take it one step further and I grab an alignment stick and place it down the lead side of the shaft and then grip the club, again, I'm going to do the same thing. Now you can see this promotes a nice straight line right here. Swing to the top, come back down. You can see I'm coming back down to this position where everything is in a nice square position, nice straight lines. Again, this is going to massively help you when it comes to hitting consistent drives. So once you've done that a couple times, then it's time to hit a shot. You need to go through this routine. Club face down first, point it where you want the ball to start. Then from there, take your left hand, place it on the club and get that left forearm and that shaft in one straight line. Build your stance out and then bring your right arm in from underneath the club or from the side of the club. And that's then gonna build you this awesome setup position. So once you've then done that, then you're ready to hit a driver. Straight line at address, straight line at impact. Here is what it should look like. So let's now move into tip number two. Now, in order to do that, we got to put Bryson back up on the screen. Now, for tip number two, we are looking at how Bryson starts his golf swing. Now, this is crucial to get right. So what we see here is Bryson starts his swing with a pressure shift from his left foot to his right foot, kind of like a jump start on a car. He's jump starting his swing right here. Now, as he does this, he pushes out of his left leg, and that gets his pressure shifting to his right foot. Now, he does this for a number of reasons. Number one, it kickstarts the swing with some momentum. This momentum allows us to swing this club as fast as we can around our body. Now, for every golfer, that's going to be slightly different, but think about it this way. It's the longest club in our bag in terms of shaft length. This club is designed to go as far as possible. So if you can simply start your swing with momentum and it adds 3, 4, 5 miles an hour to your club head speed, that is going to equate to 10, 15, maybe even 20 yards of extra distance. That means you could have 2 clubs less into every single green and the game becomes a lot easier. The second reason is when you have your body doing this little bit of a pressure shift, it actually gets the club working back on a beautiful plane. So it helps you get your takeaway into a good position. And then the third key reason is it allows you to get a little bit more, and this is crucial for driver, behind the golf ball. Now this then allows you to be able to shift your weight, shallow the club, and be able to have that neutral to slightly positive angle of attack. So as you can see, one simple movement is giving us 3 major benefits right there. Now, what is it that I see so many amateurs do? Well, the first one is I see amateurs, they don't use their body at all in the takeaway. Everything is just sort of arms. They maybe lift the arms up and it whips the club inside, or maybe they just pick the club up to the outside where it gets very hingy. From these positions, it's gonna be very difficult to swing the club correctly on plane, and also from there, it's gonna be very difficult to have any speed. Or the other situation that I see is golfers, they get into a position to where they collapse too much, or maybe they rotate way too early off the ball. They collapse onto their left leg. Now, often from here, they're then going to have to react by falling back, standing up and throwing their ankles out. Again, going to be very difficult to have any speed, any sort of consistency if you're swinging like that. So how do I want you to train this? This is a real key sort of question right here that we've got to come up with a simple solution. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to set up to this driver, and I just want you then to lift your right heel off the ground slightly. So you can see from the downline view, I've just lifted that right heel slightly. Now, to start your swing, I want you to feel like you slam that heel down. You slam that heel down, and as you do that, you then take the club away. And as you can see, as I do that slam, it shifts my pressure from being more so on my left foot into my right foot. Then from there, I can start to whip the club back, shift, and you'll find it so much easier to actually get behind the ball, hit up on it, be able to still shift your weight, side bend, do all the things that we want to do, rotate, but have that beautiful high launch, low spin sort of situation that we're looking for. So try it here, lift that right heel up, slam it down and take the club back, and then from there, swing all the way through. So here's what this one should look like. Right heel up, slam it down, swing back, and swing through. Now, once you've done that a couple of times, then you can do it where you don't actually slam that foot down. You just feel like there's a little push off the left foot onto the right foot. Some people use, say, the Gary Player knee kick in and then go. Some players just like to push off that left foot. But either way, it's just a subtle movement. Doesn't want to be this big lateral sway. It's a subtle movement that helps you kickstart your swing with some momentum. That coupled with the straight line with the lead forearm and the club is going to help you start to hit some longer, straighter drives. So let me hit it one more time. Then we'll shove Bryson back up on the screen so you can take a look there. And you are going to start to hit some longer drives if you can do this movement correctly.